Hello, my dear students. I am Pooja Bansal, your English teacher. Today, I am going to start a topic in English grammar, that is articles. Article, first of all, we will discuss the definition of articles. An article is a word used to modify a noun. Dear students, I think you all have studied the topic article in your previous class also. But this time we have in detail. So first of all, I would tell you the definition. I would make you understand it. An article is a word. Right? Try to understand it. An article is a word which is used to modify a noun. Dear students, you should know what is a noun and how articles are used with the noun. Noun is a person, place, an object or any idea. The students, you have studied about noun also. Ki noun, jo hai, these are kind of those words which tell us something about a place, about a person, about any object or any idea. So, the words which are used to modify a noun, that is called articles. So students, there are two types of articles. Here, two types of articles. First is definite articles and second is indefinite article. Indefinite article, we put the, and indefinite article, we put a and an. So in indefinite articles, you all know that there are two words, a and an. A and an are called indefinite articles. Actually, what's the meaning of indefinite articles? Indefinite here means which is not definite, which is not particular, which is not particular or not specific. They are used when we do not speak of any particular person or thing. Right? So, a and and are called indefinite articles and they are used when we do not speak of any particular person or a thing. Indefinite means which is not definite, which is not particular or specific. Now, dear students, we will discuss the correct use of a. Here, the first rule is, when words begin with the sound of a consonant. Dear students, you all know that which are which letters are consonants and which behaves like vowel. Except A, E, I, O, U, all the letters in English, these are consonants. So try to understand your first rule. When words begin with the sound of a consonant. Means a word which gives us, which produces a sound of a consonant. For example, here, a book. Here, b, b. B is a consonant, right? So, it produces a sound of a consonant, a book. A chair. Here, you can say that produces a sound of ch, chair. A girl, g. A tree, t. Right? So, you can see here when the words begin with the sound of a consonant, means a word which produces a consonantal sound, we can use a with those words. Is this clear? In the second rule, we can see when words begin with a vowel but produces a sound of u. Try to understand this rule that word begins with a vowel but produce a sound of U. You can see here with the help of example, a university. Here you can see U. U is a vowel but it produces a sound of U. You can see A, E, I, O, U is a, these are vowels but these are produces the sound of U. So, we will put here a university, a European, is your vowel but produces a sound of U, a European. Here, useful. U is also your vowel but it produces a sound of U. That's why we will put here a useful. Now, here is our third rule. When words begin with O, O is also our vowel but produce a sound of W, as in water. Right? Again, I am repeating this rule. When words begin with O, O is our vowel but produce the sound of W. For example, a 1 rupee note. You can see here, one. In the word one, it starts with the letter O, which is our vowel, but it produces a sound W, a 1 rupee note. In the same way, there is another example, a one-way road, a one-eyed man. Clear? So you can see here, these words start with a vowel, but produces a sound of W. Okay. So in fourth rule, A is used before a singular noun that is countable when mentioned for the first time and represents no particular person or thing. So try to understand it. A is used before a singular noun. You know what is a noun, so you can also understand which is singular and which is plural noun. And that singular noun which is countable also. And the thing is when it is mentioned for the first time. And it represents no particular person or thing. Means when a word is used for the first time and there is no particularness in the word, in the sentence. Then we can use here. For example, I saw a monkey. Sorry. I saw a money. A money. Another is he ate a mango. A mango.